important. Your health matters today. So today is the final day of Prostate Cancer Awareness Month. It's a time to, again, mourn all of the courageous people we've lost too soon to this disease. But it's also a time to raise awareness on how to catch it early and prevent more of those deaths from happening. So I'm joined in studio by Dr. Josh Wilner, family medicine physician at Kaiser Permanente in Sacramento, with what we need to know about prostate cancer, which is the most common cancer among men. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
So me personally, my husband is turning 40 this year, and I'm always concerned about his health, and I'm always thinking about prostate cancer and screening. And now the age kind of varies when you're supposed to get tested, but for men who have maybe family history, for African American men, that kind of changes when it comes to screening, right?
Correct. So typically, most men, we start screening around the age of 50. And some men who are maybe African American, have a family history, multiple people in their family, we might start screening as early as 45 or 40, depending on that person's, you know, risks.
The risks involved. And what are the symptoms that we definitely need to pay attention to if something's not right?
Many times there are no symptoms initially in the process. And when it could become symptomatic, you might have difficulty urinating, decreased flow of that urine, sometimes some abnormal weight loss that was unintentional, sometimes some fatigue associated with it.
And when those symptoms start to show, what does that mean? Does that mean maybe it might be a little bit too late to catch it in the process?
It could mean that.
Okay.
You know, that's one of the things. But, you know, naturally, as men get older, their prostate enlarges, and you could get some of those symptoms associated with it. And so it's really important to have these conversations early and to make certain you have those conversations with your physician, make that appointment, and figure out if screening for prostate cancer is right for you at that time.
Sure, sure. And the way screening goes these days, I mean, things have changed over the years. I think, again, some men are a little bit skeptical, or they're a little bit hesitant to talk to the doctor about it or get screened for it because we know about the finger test or whatever. But that has changed too. I mean, that's also a part of the screening process, but it's different now too.
The initial screen would be a blood test called a PSA. And so it would be a blood test that you could do annually, every other year. It really depends on the individual and what that first test comes back as and their risk factors with how often you screen. Mm-hmm. But typically it is starting with a blood test called a PSA.
Okay, a PSA. And if you do catch it early, what kind of terms or words of encouragement would you give somebody if you do come back with a positive result?
And well, the test has some false positives. So there's some reasons why it could be high that is not related to prostate cancer alone. And so it's really about working with your physician, usually rechecking that test, and then very often you know, referral to the urologist to discuss the next steps.
And establishing that dialogue is super important. What does treatment also look like too for someone who is going through prostate cancer?
You know, a lot of that could be surgery. It could be some chemotherapy, it could be some radiation therapy. There are some other medications that are out there as well. And so it really depends on what level of prostate cancer and, you know, the patient's health problems that they have.
Right, right. And it doesn't necessarily have to be a death sentence if we do get a diagnosis of prostate cancer, correct?
Correct. Most prostate cancers are not very aggressive and they will not move from your prostate, but there's always some that will. And, you know, that's why I always recommend men who are somewhere between the ages of 40 and 70 to start coming to your doctor, have those conversations.
Yeah, I mean, it highlights even bigger importance of men's health, right? You need to put that first. A lot of people have family on the mind, your career, whatever, but your health also matters, right? Okay. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning and giving us what we need to know about prostate cancer health and awareness. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Yes, of course. Okay.